Governor Ayade, I appointed 38,000 political aides to reduce poverty. Cross River State Governor Ben Ayade said he appointed 38,000 political aides to reduce poverty in the state. In an interview with Arise TV, Ayade said the aim of the political appointments was to give him the emotional and social temperature to take advantage of his business connection to bring value to Cross River State. He stated that his 38,000 aides are bringing value to his government and that the several projects going on in the state needs people to manage it. In politics, talks is cheap. I have history. I know clearly that poverty is extreme, and I decided to bring 38,000 young people into the dining table to allow me the emotional and social temperature to take advantage of my business connection to bring value to Cross River State. These people are bringing values. I have several projects ongoing. All of this needs people to manage. Besides, let's deal with it. If we look at the principles, section 14 of our constitution, the primary purpose of government is the welfare and security for the people, he said. He continued, of what use will it be to build a superhighway or a deep sea port when 4.5 million people are dying out of hunger? It is better to put food on a table than to put food on concrete. These 38,000 people have not only brought value, they've reduced poverty. Speaking on his defection to the APC, the governor said the move became necessary due to the challenge in his state. Cross River State is challenged. We've lost oil wells. We've lost our territory. We seem to come from a minority section. We can't also afford extreme opposition, and I've always believed that moderation is the value, he added. Well, in politics, I believe that people that are in politics, they look at the future. And those that are done in it understood what is going to happen in time to come. That is why you see Nigerian politicians defect from one political party to another. Not any other things. There are something they are looking for. Because nobody wants a place that is a failure. But I don't understand him. He belongs to the party PDP. Why does he defect to APC? Because the APC government at us now is a failure government. It's a government that has not made any provision. It's a government that does not care for human value. It's a government that does not know those who put him there. In other words, they did whatever they like. Now, when the APC government, talking about President Muhammadu Buhari, when he was coming, when he was campaigning, he has made so many manifestos, but all the manifestos, we have not seen it. But the one that continued to ring in people's mind is this slogan. They say APC change, APC change. Everybody were thinking that yes, we have found a man that can change this country for the better. People were happy. That is why on the polling grounds, people went there spending their time and energy to vote for him in order to change Nigeria from what it used to be into a new Nigeria. But little did we know that this voting we have casted is going to land us in a river that we will never come out. But today we have seen the result of what people were thinking about. Nobody knew that APC is like this. Now, why will a governor, a man like Ayade, decided to go to APC? APC government that does not value human, they do not think of the citizen of the country. Right now, in the 36th state of Nigeria, we are experiencing war. We are experiencing war. We are experiencing pandemonium. We are experiencing catastrophe. We are experiencing calamity. Then why will somebody not think to decamp to such a party instead of remaining in PDP? Now, as such, I know that all the parties are corrupted, but I think PDP is preferred because people are testifying that when PDP was on board, this kind of suffering was not experienced until this present administration come up. So talking about his appointment, said in the news, he has appointed 38,000 people as aides to work. I think to me is a very good move because it is better to develop people than to begin to hold one project or the other while people in the state are dying of hunger and starvation. I think he is not wrong. He has been trying. You know, in the social media, he has been condemned that he does not know how to employ workers. I think to me, I give him credit because he has tried. The 38,000 people he has employed as a political aide, as such, he has put food on their table. They are not lacking anything. He said that all the projects he's running in the state, the people are running it. That it is better to provide employment for the youth in the state than to begin to construct roads from Jericho to Jerusalem, from Lagos to Sokoto, and other projects that does not benefit the people. But that does not mean that he has not constructed road or he has not built, social amenities. I believe in Cross River State, there are social amenities where people can go, where people can go and be studied or be treated. And as well, I believe there are portable drinkable water in the state. There are hospitals in the state. There are schools in the state. I believe for the couple of time, we don't have problem from the state. I think to me, the man is trying because there is nothing you will do on this earth when people will not praise you, when you do not care for the people you are leading. Your work become a meagre and unsatisfactory kind. So to me, I praise him, he should continue. But what I don't want from him is this to come to APC. He should be very careful because he can be deceived.